Well, my name is Garrett. I work here on the Niña da Pinta, and so we are a traveling museum around the U.S., and we were built down in Brazil. This ship here is a caravel, and we're a replica of the Niña da Pinta of Columbus's exploration voyages. But this ship right here, all handmade by Portuguese shipwrights down in Brazil. No power tools were used to build them. But back in the early 80s, one of our founders was working for the Peace Corps back in the early 80s, came across a small village that didn't even have electricity, and saw that these shipwrights here were building the local fishermen smaller fishing vessels entirely by hand. And he recognized those techniques as a naval historian. And so that's why this ship here is the world's most authentic. It's due to how she's built. And it took about 32 months and about 500 trees to build this ship here. And so we travel around the U.S. We teach people about Columbus and caravels and sailing in the exploration era. And it's an awesome opportunity if you get to sign up with us.
So what is this for?
This right here is the tiller. It connects to the rudder. It sits about 7 feet down below the water, equal to the keel. And that's how you steer the ship. The ship's wheel was invented until 1703 by the British Navy. And so 200 years before that, they're using the big stick here. You point it to the right, that turns you left, and you point it to the left, that turns you right. And you hold it in the middle here to go straight where your compass is. And that's how you know which direction you're going.
How many people can move this at a time?
Well, generally, it only takes one person to move the tiller, but when you start hitting 10-foot seas, it's a different story. You got about 3 to 5 of them on it, getting thrown around like rag dolls. But you never want to lash this thing down, because if it breaks, that's your only means of steering the vessel. So you're always going to keep people on it. They're going to break before it does.
So how many people can you hold on this boat?
Well, Columbus would have maxed out over here at 24 people, 26 on the Pinta, and 40 on the Santa Maria. But nowadays, we max out at 7 crew members over here and 9 on the Pinta. That's including your captains. And so we got our own bunks down below today, but originally they all got to sleep up here on the deck, so they could fit a lot more people up here. But 500 years ago, they didn't have room for living quarters. They had cows, chickens, pigs, goats, rabbits, horses, barrels of wine and water, a year's worth for every man on board, and all sorts of different preserved foods like salted meats and pickled fruits and vegetables, all those things stored down below in barrels. And so it was packed to the rim. They had a year's worth for every man on board, so they didn't have any room for living quarters, and that's why they had to sleep up here. And only one person went down there. He started out from 7 to 9 years old, and by the time he turned 14, he's a full-fledged sailor up here on the deck with everybody else. But they reported directly under the captain, so they were often trained as officers when they hit the age of 14. And so you go from the worst job, taking care of the animals, smell really bad, cleaning up after them, and also acting as a bilge pump, hailing out all the water from the bottom of the ship and throwing it off the side. And so that was your job, and then once you came up here, you got to come back here with the officers and the captain and go up on the raised deck and learn navigation, things like that. But only the deckhands were allowed up on the deck, or out on the main deck. No one was allowed back here in the shade or up on the raised deck, because this is where you steer and up there is where you navigate. And a crew that knows how to do that doesn't quite need a captain. And that's why they all just stay out there 24/7. Nothing but the shade of the sails.
Thank you for your time. Hope you had a great day, Sonic.
Thank you.
Make it count.